Hey, what up? This is Eddie04, and today we're gonna dive into the chase right away. I noticed that we have had a couple of issues with the Xbox 360 Controller Emulator. Some of you guys have been asking me some questions about, hey, this unconfigured device GUID. So we're gonna dive in right away. I'm gonna literally replicate the same situation here, and I am actually using a different setup. As you can see, this is a different computer. I'm gonna test out to see if I can load the game controller. You'll notice that it doesn't work. And then I'm gonna go ahead and fix the issue. I'm gonna teach you how to fix it today, right? So let's dive in right away. So right off the bat here, we have Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, which is the game that we test every single time, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead and hit and play. And I have my PS4 controller here, which is connected through a USB cable. If you're interested in any of these, like the controller or the cable, you can go ahead and check the description below. Now, as you can see, you know, my test number one is actually pressing on the buttons to verify that I can go forward or I can move through. As you can see, this is not responding. So I'm just gonna go ahead and exit out of the game. And we are doing this pretty much live. You can see here, the game doesn't respond. So I'm gonna exit out of the game, and you know how this works. So we make sure that the game has stopped, and we are gonna go to the game folder. So in this case, I'm gonna click here, I'm gonna manage, and I'm gonna go to browse files. And in this case, we have game folder. Now I am using the same emulator that we have in the description below, as well as in the other videos, but I'm gonna go ahead and just drop in the Xbox 360 emulator as always. Just copy and paste that here. So after we copy the Xbox 360 controller emulator into our game folder, I'm gonna go ahead and right click on it and hit and run as administrator, which is the normal process just to make sure that we have all the permissions to run this current installer. In this case, remember the Xinput x1_3dll file needs to hit and create so that it'll be added into the game folder. And then here's the point where you're asking for configuration for that game controller. You can just go ahead and hit on next. You're gonna start searching for the configuration online. As you can see here, it doesn't find the configuration. It just stayed blank. It would usually show you the results on the bottom. In this case, when I hit and finish, boom, there's the error message. PAD0 misconfigured device. And this is because it cannot find a configuration file for that game controller. Now, to solve this issue, it's really straightforward. That message is gonna keep on coming out until you fix the configuration. What I recommend at this point, which is actually the x360ce.ini file, just come here to the configuration or the controller setup, and then just go ahead and click on clear. Now at this point, when you clear it, you'll notice that the game controller box or check mark, it changes from red to green. That means that it's already connected. Unfortunately, there's nothing configured. I don't know if the developers changed their server or anything like that, but there's no game controller configuration that I could find for my PS4 controller, which is actually detected as a wireless controller on Windows 10. I don't even know if it's a Windows 10 issue, but I know how to set it up. So in this case, what you could do is try and set up a configuration that they have available for the controllers. So they'll have a list of different controllers they have available here. Unfortunately, these setups that I see here, I try to load a couple of those, even a PS4 controller that I noticed that they had for Sony somewhere here, DualShock 4, and it didn't work. So what I did in my case, and this will solve your situation, is just go ahead and hit an auto. And when you hit an auto, he's gonna just go ahead and load whatever he can find, whatever configuration he can enable here, and put it into the game controller. Now, as you can see here, I'm gonna start using my PS4 controller and I can move, but the buttons are configured in a weird way. So when I press the analog stick, the right stick, it does something totally different. So today we're gonna go ahead and set up the right buttons. And if you don't wanna go through all this process of setting up manually yourself, you can go ahead and download the control configuration that I created just for you guys in this video. You can go ahead and check it in the description below. Now, as you can see, I'm pressing buttons and it's doing something totally different, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and set this up in the proper way so that it can work. Okay, so we're gonna start configuring the game controller with similar settings for my PS4 controller, which should work for anybody else. And you can replicate this same thing in your Xbox 360 emulator, or you can just go ahead and get that bonus file, which is added in the description below. So right away, the trigger is going to be access. Or trigger over here is going to be access. So with that, we can go test our PS4 controller again. And as you can see, my left stick, my right stick, A, B, Y, X, here, here, my buttons, my bumpers, and my triggers. Right, so after that, you can just go ahead and click save. Now, as you know, I already know on this computer, Xinput1_3.dll doesn't work. So I'm just gonna go ahead and close this. I'm gonna change my Xinput name to 9_1_0. Just gonna open the Xbox 360 emulator one more time, just because I wanna confirm that it's actually running on the right Xinput. How can I see that? At the very button on the right corner, it's gonna show me what kind of Xinput it's actually loading. Boom. And there you got it. This is how you actually fix the unconfigured GUID issue from your Xbox 360 emulator. All right, so for the bonus section, I have my game controller here, which is already configured. I'm gonna go ahead and clear it out as well. And I'm just gonna teach you how to load the right configuration that I added into the description below. So I'm gonna head, clear this out. I'm gonna save it. This is the same way as it was when it started. And as I mentioned, you can use the configuration file that I have added into the description below. So you go ahead and paste it here, which will replace the file. And we're gonna run the emulator one more time. And now, as you can see with the new configuration, we have everything set up properly by just adding that x360ce.ini file. Hey, so I hope you liked the video. Go ahead and hit on that like button. And for more videos like this, just go ahead and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to click on the notification bell so you can be notified whenever I release a brand new video. This was Eddie04. See you on the next one. And in the meantime, go ahead and watch any of these videos. Peace.